Hello everyone, welcome back to the sixth lecture on the design of fasteners. And today we will be starting the second part of the chapter, that is the design of rivets. As we saw in the previous, okay, there are basically two types of joints. One is permanent and one is temporary. The fastener which we saw, it comes under the category of the temporary joint. Then now the category which we are viewing, it is of the permanent joint. That means once you join the two parts, then it is very difficult to disassemble them, or you cannot disassemble without damaging them. Okay, this is what the difference between the riveted joint and the fasteners. Okay, so we'll study in detail what exactly these joints are. Okay, see, in steel structure, okay, such as roof truss, okay, boiler shells, ship building, etc. Now its various members which constitute the structure are connected to one another. Now how they are connected? Now they are connected by means of the rivet joints. Mechanical joints, they are broadly classified into two classes. That's what I told you, that is the non-permanent, for example fastener, and the permanent, for example rivets. Okay, so this is what the basic introduction to the rivet joints. And you have to note that the rivet joint is used in the structure only if there is a must need, because if you use it unnecessarily, it will weaken the section due to the holes. Okay, so you have to make it use of it only when it is required. Fine. Next, now rivet and riveting. Now basically the rivet has three parts. One is the tail, that is the taper portion. One is the shank portion, and one is the head portion. Okay, now rivet is a short cylindrical bar. Okay, it's a cylindrical bar with the head is the integral part of it. So which is head? Now this is the head, which is integral part of this whole bar. Okay, and it consists of the upside down, called as a head. Of course it is a head. A long part, now this is the long part of the rivet, which we call as a shank or a body. And the lower part, this is the tapered part of the section, we call it as a tail. Okay, so this is what the basic structure of the rivet, what we use for the riveting. Okay, I hope it is clear. We'll move to the further, the types of rivet joints. Okay, now there are different types of rivet joint. Okay, like as I mentioned here, lap joints. Next, there are butt joints. Okay, in the lap and butt joints also, there are again many part, like single riveted lap joint, double riveted lap joint, okay, double cover plate lap joint. Okay, so these are classified into different types. So these two are the basic types of rivets. So these are the diagram for lap joint. This is for lap joint, and this is for a butt joint. Okay, this is what the information, as I told you, the two plates that are to be joined are brought in face to face. Okay, such that an overlap exists, as shown in the figure. Means if you want to use a lap joint, there should be overlap between the two plates. What do you mean overlap? If this is a first plate, then there has to be overlapping of this plate like this. Okay. Next, the rivets are inserted on the overlapping portion. Okay. Of course, if this is the overlap, so here they insert the rivet. This is what the meaning of the that point. So there are many, again as I told you, single or multiple rows of rivets are used. Okay. Depending upon the number of rows, the rivets, again they are classified into different types, that single riveted lap joint, double riveted lap joint, etc. Next one is butt joint. Now, what is the difference between the lap joint and butt joint is that the plates that are brought to each other without forming any overlap, means overlap it does not exist in case of the butt joint. Riveted joints, they are formed between the each of the plates and one or two cover plates. So this is what the general layout of the butt joint. So butt joint, again they are classified as the single row, double row, zigzag, okay, etc. So these are the different classification of the butt joints. Okay, thank you.